we got a chance to take it.
Devon didn't get one, did they?
Thank you. Devon Eagles rugby league team reinforced their Southwest Conference Championship credentials at Exmouth over the weekend with an impressive win against the Newton Abbott-based Devon Shark side. The Eagles came out on top by 72 points to 16.
Joined them this week. He's not gone with his bucket and spade, though. Dave went down to Devon to discover a thriving rugby league scene and a surprising amount of history in the game. His first stop, Plymouth Hoe.
Down here in Devon, it's not all about cream teas and picture postcards. This is a county that takes its sport very seriously. Even fighting the Armada had to wait for the end of a bowls game. I like to think it was Crown Green and that Sir Francis here was a relative of the Drake twins who played for Hull. But who really knows?
Oh, I like that one.
No, I don't like it that much.
They still bowl on the hoe, although rather more sedately, without the same sense of imminent invasion. Yeah! History comes up in a costume, Plymouth, and rugby league has a surprising amount of history here. Rob Stockwell is coach of the Plymouth Titans, who are keeping the flag flying for the game in the city these days.
Yeah, it goes back as far as 1912. Plymouth had a team in the Northern Union and were playing against teams such as Hulkingston Rovers, St Helens. That sadly disintegrated after a certain amount of years, but not before a couple of internationals were played down here. England and Wales played down here.
And teams from the north came down here on tour, I believe, as well.
Yeah, Hull and Hull KR actually played a three-game tour back in the 40s in the heart of Cornwall. They had three games against each other, and that was in the summer as well, funnily enough.
Over to the other side of the Tamar, which you can just see over there.
Just over there, yeah.
It's a point of affinity with the north, but Devon seems to have more moors than Lancashire and Yorkshire put together. The classic novel of the Devon Moors, Lorna Doone, was written by R.D. Blackmore, an echo there of Mike Blackmore, the West Countryman who played on the wing for Hull KR in the 1960s.
There was another Devonian making his way in rugby league at the time. Bob Fleet came north from Torquay at the age of 17 and was part of that famous Swinton three-quarter line, Speed, Fleet, Buckley and Stopford, that won trophies in the 60s. Fleet's contribution was 90 tries in 376 games.
Oh, yeah.
We tracked him down to the quaint West Country fishing village of Bolton.
And what did you think of it when you got up here? Was it a bit of a culture shock to you?
Certainly was. I'd never seen a pit before. And I'm away from the station. I was met at the station on the following Thursday. We travelled through Salford, Swinton, on the top road, as they called it then days. Well, you had Ashcroft Colliery, Newtown Colliery, it was about four collieries.
Different world.
Different world completely. Mm-hmm. And, I mean, I did leave a few palm trees behind when I left Torquay.
And, of course, you weren't the only one. There was quite an influx of West Country players. Yeah. Players like Blackmore and
Mike
Paul.
Mike was the captain of the Devon side when I was in it.
Yeah.
Ted Bonner, of course, who turned professional. They went to Hull KR. Paul was one other
Graham
one.
Paul, yeah. You were part of a very successful Swinton side, weren't you? A great three-quarter line with yourself and Johnny Speed outside you. I have to ask you this question. Who was faster, Speed or Fleet?
with a name like Speed, it must be him. He had the speed, I had the brains.
That same rugby league hotbed of Torquay has produced three Super League players. Ian Henderson at Bradford, Kevin with Wakefield, and Andrew maybe leading the Castleford Tigers back to the top flight. There are no Super League players yet down the coast at Exmouth, but the little town where the River Exe meets the sea is home to the East Devon Eagles. They're based at the homely Exmouth Rugby Union Club, where the director of rugby has no qualms about promoting the other code.
We have had a few guys who are predominantly league players that have come on board with us, but it is made up generally of lads wanting to come and try the game, and one or two that perhaps played it when they were younger.
And what's the potential of it down here, do you think?
I think it can grow. This has been a good, successful first season. I think it's important that the South West clubs consolidate that and continue to grow. And who knows from where we'll go then.
One thing rugby league traditionalists really lament is the death of the county cups. There's no Lancashire Cup or Yorkshire Cup as we knew them for 100 years, but there is the Devon Challenge Cup, and that's what they're playing for here at Exmouth tonight.
Titans led for most of the game, largely thanks to the efforts of Gavin Boak, that great big bloke. There wasn't much rugby league experience in their side, apart from the second row Mark Molyneux, whose high shot early in the game earned him 10 minutes in the sin bin. Looks familiar? Well, he's a cousin of Warrington's Adrian Morley. The Despite taking an early battering from the Titans, the East Devon Eagles hung in there and snatched victory late in the game. In front of a crowd of around 400 Devonians, the Eagles revived a fine rugby league tradition, lifting a county cup.
Do you feel like a cup final?
Hell yeah. Because the actual atmosphere when JJ, the lad on the mic, got the crowd going, it was you could sense lift the game the last 10 minutes, I'm sure you agree. The hits are being put in there in defence were phenomenal. Some big shockers going in, and a lot of boys were feeling it on both sides, so that's good.
There you have it. Almost 100 years after the launch of the code in Devon, it's up and running again with clubs in Exeter and Newton Abbott as well. And this time, it might not be built on sand.
Dave Hadfield off the beaten track. Look.
Still going.
Still going.
Guys.